Hey, good afternoon, Terrance. This is a quick demo video for you for your Saberforge Crossguard. This is an older model that you sent to me. It had a veteran tier install from them, which means basically it was a static chassis. You had a one button setup here with a recharge port down here. I've obviously taken all that out. I've given you a two button setup. So your top switch will be your power. Your bottom switch will be your auxiliary. I made this into a completely removable chassis that I'll show you here in a second. And you had inbuilt LEDs for your two quillions and your main blade. So what we've done is we've switched this to a Neopixel setup, and you've got Carl Chen V4 Neopixel connectors and all three of your emitters here. So your main one quillion, and of course the other quillion. All right. You still maintain your blade retention screws, which if you look down here, it's the silver grub screw here, another silver grub screw here. Now this main blade actually has two places that you can use for blade retention. Now you've got this longer guy here, which you really don't need to use, because you can use this one over here on the other side, which is a little bit further up, so it will grab your blade a bit more. I would just use that one. All right. Now to get to your chassis, what you want to do is unscrew your pommel. This is the only place on this saber that opens. So when you take this off, I'm just trying not to drop it. There is a small spacer here that I glued on. I printed, I glued that onto the pommel. That does not come off. All right. That's to help push the chassis forward. I needed just a little bit more material to get the speaker past that little grill section so it didn't cause any distortion in your sound. So that's what that's for. All right. You'll see your speaker here. You can just go just like that and your chassis will fall out. So this is, of course, your chassis. You've got now a Proffie board, easy access to your SD card and your micro USB. You've got one sound font on here for now. It's my sound font. And there's a copy of the config file that I used on your SD card, so you can take that and you can make changes. This is set up for a one blade style type of setup, so all three of your blades are basically one blade style on this particular one. All right, so right in front of the board, you've got a kill switch. All right, so you can leave your battery in here and just take the chassis out and flip your switch. You've got a removable battery set up here, so please remember spring size your negative. Now you are in Germany, so I won't be sending a battery with a Saber. It takes an 18650 keep power battery. Now I have the sticker off of this one, which is what I test all of my Sabers with, but I have one right here and it looks like this, right? So we can focus in on that. That's the type of battery you need. Now it doesn't necessarily have to be keep power. These are always what I recommend. The important thing is it's a protected cell. All right, so you'll see a lot of 18650 batteries out there that aren't protected. And when they're not protected, they're not as long as this. All right. So, so number one, the chassis was made for this length of battery, so it needs to be protected. Number two, it's always just way safer to use a protected cell battery in your Saber. All right. So remember that, please. If you need to rewind this demo, there's a picture of that and an explanation for the battery that you'll need. All right. So we'll go ahead. Spring side, negative side of the battery, we'll put it in here. Clip it in, it stays in there nice. This is, just put some stuff on your chassis so it didn't look so plain. It has a 28 millimeter Smuggler's Outpost Elite speaker in it, so it does sound very good. You did have a 28 millimeter speaker in it before, but it was kind of an off-brand speaker in it, and I did test the Saber before I broke it down. This does sound a lot better, and you'll notice the difference, obviously, because you had this Saber before you sent it to me. All right. And then up along the piece right here, it just says Solo Sabers for me. All right. It's using a Smuggler's Outpost Switch Pixel PCB set. So this PCB right here makes contact with a 14-pin PCB that you can almost see in there. I know it's pretty dark, but it never comes out. That is a static piece. All right. So when we put our battery in our chassis, we can just come over here and turn on.
I met you in the desert because I needed to see you. I needed you to see him. Who you are.
So I said I had one sound font on here. That was a lie. I've got two. All right. I've got Kyberphonics Kylo. I put that on here. And then I also have my own sound font on here as well. So you have two sound fonts. Let me know if you want to keep this sound font. I'll leave it on, and then we can just add that to the total. I'll ship that over to Jesse over at Kyber Final. All right. But once you get that chassis on, you can put it in any way you like, as long as this piece goes in first. All right. Just slide it right in there. Try not to push on the center of the speaker, and then use the pommel to push the chassis all the way in. You just come over here and screw that in. And when you lock it all the way down nice and tight, it locks the chassis in place with those pins, and now you can come over here and hit power. So you got those LEDs are firing up, so are these, and of course your main blade. Now this Saber sounds pretty beefy, but you should be pretty happy with the sound quality. Auxiliary up down here. And you've got twist off. Now you may know this already, but I'm going to go ahead and say it anyway. All right, because I'm not sure if you've owned a Neopixel lightsaber in the past, but even though you have LEDs on these blade side connectors here, they're not really enough to put the old blades that you would have had for an in-hilt setup. They're mainly to light up your blade plugs, which I have right here. You know, these are your blade plugs. So you put your blade plug in there, and we turn this on, you know, you're going to get some animation from those. That's basically what that is, or to get a little bit of visual effect when you don't have a blade in. But don't expect these to light up a hollow blade. That's really not what they're for. All right. Now, I don't have three separate 1-inch diameter blades. I have this one test blade for now. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of put it in each side and then in the main emitter and show you that these are lighting up like they're supposed to. All right. I'm just going to hold this in there like this with the button facing the camera and turn it on. So you've got that blade lighting up. We'll turn it off like that. Turn this around, put it in the other side. That blade lights up, right? And now we'll put it in the main piece right here. And of course it lights up your main emitter as well. So you will need three Neopixel blades. You'll need a regular length blade for your main blade, and you'll need two side quillions, probably a little bit, you know, probably about half the length of this test blade right here. But just to show you that everything in there is working, we're going to go ahead, let me get an Allen key, and we'll lock down this blade one, for this main blade. So we'll lock down this main blade, and we'll kind of do some testing just to show you some different things here. Lock that blade down. All right. Now, if you want to change color of this, you just hold down auxiliary and hit power, and you'll hear this audible cue. That right there. Now you can just twist the saber and change it to any color you like. And when you find one you like, just hit power. So now we've locked in that red unstable, and all three blades will change the same color at the same time, so they'll all be in unison. It can be a little bit difficult to pick up on camera, right? The blades look kind of bright on camera, but if you can see that against my hand, you know, then you can see that against my hand for your quillions, same color. And twist it off if you like, and then if you want to go to another sound font, hit auxiliary. Apologize. And this one is mine. Right? This one is kind of an orange unstable. Twist it off. They both have soundtracks. So if you want to play that soundtrack, just do a long press on the power when the saber's off. And do another long press to turn it off. All right, we'll go to another one.
Wherever you are, you are hard to find.
So this is the one we started with. And this is the soundtrack for that. We're looking up that color. Turn it off. All right, just like that. And we'll go ahead and we'll take your, or I'll take my blade out of here rather, and put your three blade retention, or I'm sorry, your three blade plugs. It's been kind of a long day. All right, so we'll lock those down in there. And this way also, too, I don't forget to send these because that would be bad. All right, so we'll lock this down in there. Come in, we'll put the third and final one in. Lock it down in there. I'm just, for now, making them even with the quillion guards right here. You can put them all the way in if you like, but we'll hit power. So you've got light up here, here and here, right? And then, of course, when we're done, we'll come over here. I'm going to turn the saber on and then take the chassis out to show you that the kill switch works. All right, so we'll come over here and unscrew the pommel. Slide the chassis out. You can hear it still running until we come over here and flip the switch. And then it kills everything. And when you eventually do have to take the battery out to charge it, do it from the positive side by your speaker. And you pop it out with your finger. All right. And then when you're done, just put this back in for safekeeping. But that is basically your Saberforge Crossguard. Let me know if you have any questions. And I will box this up and get it out in the mail to you by tomorrow. Thanks, man.